when it comes to formulating a story, I'm not sure that you can beat it into submission through analytics. I think you might be guided in a certain way to identify that a certain demographic or a certain group of people like a certain actor or star or a certain pacing, and you can mash that all together. But it sure doesn't seem like you can absolutely science your way with deep molecular capability into telling a great story. And by the way, here's an anecdote, and I don't know anything about this, I'll just mention it, which is Amazon and Amazon Studios, by my observation, I have no insight, has been doing original shows for quite some time, and they use, presumably, data, so it was indicated, and they've had whatever success they've had, and they now have a show called Transgender, which I just began to watch, and it seems rather intriguing. And I just would wonder if, I don't know that if that data got them to transgender. Maybe it did. If I had to guess, I would say there might have been some creative hand in it that didn't end up at that show after a formula. So I think it's advantageous to look at all the data available, but I think it applies best and most for certain parts of a business and not every part of a business. And I think that the part of a business it likely applies least completely to is what stories you tell and how you tell them. And I don't mean to just sort of sit and call it all poetic, but I think we would probably all acknowledge that there is very personal contribution of people who are making this stuff up, and you can't necessarily plot it on a graph on your way to success. So are services that have a direct connection to a consumer advantaged? In a certain sense, yes. It's a complicated issue to say whether they're absolutely genetically advantaged versus someone who uses a retailer, like a MVPD, cable operator satellite company. But I think on the subject of content creation, I'm not sure it is at all the central element.